It's the radio guy, Dr. Mike Prince. Welcome to today's edition of the Mike Prince Show, brought to you each and every day by the good people from Attorney Lee Van Richardson, located at 1047 Austin Street in Hempstead, Texas. Give him a call at 979-826-8008 for an appointment on today. Also, want to thank the good people from the Prairie View Athletic Club. You can become a member today by simply dialing 936-857-5817. And without any further delay, we'll jump right into today's episode. Before we do so, I do want to remind you about our social media handles, Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter, all at The Mike Prince Show. YouTube channel is Open Mic Broadcast Network. Channel's been growing slowly but surely as well. Thank you guys very much for that. Also, the website, obnradio.com, and our 24-hour dial-in message line, 713-570-6736. You guys have been very responsive to our purple and gold recaps with Coach Ted White, offensive coordinator for the Panthers, and the ghost himself, Eric Dooley. Great feedback, great response, and we'll keep doing the best we can to keep you informed and our ears to the ground. Spring football concluded on last week. Purple team winning 48-30. Still some things to be done with the Panthers football program before the kickoff of August the 31st. Now, if you were listening to Coach Dooley, you heard him give his assessments of each area on the team, it kind of didn't almost pan out. He gave a B+ when he concluded, but according to the letter grades he gave out, it was really close to a 2.0 or a C. So we'll kind of see hot and cold on some areas, but nonetheless, still room for improvement, and the Panthers will be wrapping that up and working toward the ultimate goal of providing a champion for the 2019 campaign. I want to also remind you that you can get your season tickets. Football season will be here before you know it. You can secure your season pass by dialing 936-261-3970. Get your season tickets today and be a win-win for everyone involved.
Are you looking for an affordable way to increase your business? Let the Open Mic Broadcast Network lead the way. For a customized, affordable ad campaign, call 832-213-8824.
Now to the heartbeat of the season right now with baseball and softball. Baseball will have to put on their traveling shoes on the 24th, which will be Wednesday, as they'll travel to Nacogdoches to take on Stephen F. Austin. Panthers right now are 8-9 in conference play, 16-26 overall. And as we had made focus here about a month or so ago, we were going to focus on the conference games that remain. Panthers will travel to Houston on this weekend to take on Texas Southern starting Friday in a 3-game series. Now, Texas Southern and Southern are the final two series for the Panthers in conference play. There's one game that might need to be made up or might not with Pine Bluff. The Golden Lions are having a dismal season. And because of that, we can guarantee that the Panthers will have, worst case, the fourth seed. Looking at things right now, the Panthers could theoretically end up in the number two seed. Realistically, the Panthers could probably max out in the number three spot. Southern University and Grambling are holding the one and two spot. Texas Southern currently in the number three spot. It's only one game that separates those two, and that's that makeup game that could weigh in as far as a three or four position with Pine Bluff. So the Panthers will begin to position themselves for the final stretch. Now, looking at the games that remain, the best case scenario, the Panthers could end up, they win all seven games that remain, 15-9. Worst case scenario, the Panthers could end up 8-16. But nonetheless, it's going to really matter on how they finish against Texas Southern. It's no secret, the Panthers have struggled against Texas Southern. 2-16 under the leadership of Coach Riggins. All of that could be erased this weekend. Time will tell. Meanwhile, on the softball circuit, the Panthers, with a 10-2 conference record, 23-12 overall, they're second in the West and second overall in conference play. Texas Southern's 12-0. And remember, there's a huge makeup game between the Panthers and the Tigers coming up on May 4th. And those two games could pretty much determine who wins the West. It's phenomenal that Coach Barker and the Tigers are trying to get their 10th consecutive Western Division title. Hopefully the Panthers can interrupt that flow with these two huge games that will be coming up on May 4th. Meanwhile, the Panthers will be at University of Texas on the 24th to take on the Lady Longhorns. And they will have a huge homestand starting on the 26th against the Golden Lions of Pine Bluff. So the Panthers hitting all cylinders right now as they prepare for the final stretch of the softball division. And in case you had not heard, Dr. Ruth Simmons and President Lane, presidents from Texas Southern and, of course, Prairie View, were honored last night throwing out the first pitch of the Astros game. A lot of excitement behind that. And speaking of excitement, coaches are now belly aching about the transfer rule. They're saying that it has become like a free agency with the student athlete, and they can just come and go as they please right now. Well, the NCAA and Division I Council felt it was important to allow this freedom of movement, if you would, for the student athlete, because they said the coaches and ADs had gained too much power and become vindictive on who they would allow to transfer and where they could transfer to. Now, with this open portal system, it has changed the dynamics drastically. And now it's more the Power Fives that are doing this. They're belly aching and crying foul. But it's the same coaches that have liberty to jump ship if they saw a better deal across town, irregardless if they just signed a new contract. So it's one of those deals, suck it up. You can't have your cake and eat it too. And speaking of suck it up, we'll go into more detail with this on tomorrow's episode, but they're crying foul about the third assistant being rejected in baseball and saying it was a dark day for baseball. And I'm telling you now, ladies and gentlemen, we are trying to give you a forewarning. That's nothing but a smokescreen. If they really wanted to just let this be about paid assistance, they could have ran that on its own and would pass with flying colors. But our scheduled baseball expert, Olin Parker, will go into detail with that on tomorrow's episode. Prairie View Soccer and Prairie View Volleyball have released their schedules for the 2019 campaign. Coach Carvello, in her second year, will actually have about a year and a half, but technically her second year of work for the Panthers. They have some pretty intriguing matches on the schedule. And volleyball, going into the fourth year under Coach Tacho Tyler. Could this be the year of make it or break it for Coach Tyler and the Panthers volleyball programs? He's 34-87 overall career record as the leader of the Panthers, and we'll be monitoring to see how things will unfold with the volleyball program. But they've also let out a very competitive schedule on this year. Another side note is that I believe it's the third or fourth weekend. I believe the fourth weekend of September, the Panthers will be hosting a roundup. That's where all the school conference teams will come together and meet at the Billy Nix Baby Dome to have the Round Robin Tournament on the lovely campus of Prairie View A&M University. It'd be an exciting time to come out and check that out. And of course, the championship will be held on the campus of Mississippi Valley in Itabena, Mississippi. And speaking of Mississippi Valley, just when you thought Valley may have made a turn for the betterment of their basketball program, all's not easy in the land of the Delta Devils. There are many people in an uproar about the new hire of Lindsey Hunter, 17-year NBA basketball star, I guess we say. Of course, he attended Jackson State, and that was the uproar of Delta Devil Nation. There were cries and screams across the Delta that why is it that Valley feels that they need to go to Jackson to become rescued when they have qualified, bona fide, homegrown people with a vested interest in Valley as a whole? Why not give them the opportunity? Seems that's the echo across the conference. Give the home team, or should I say the home boys and the home girls, an opportunity to render their services back to their alma maters. Part of the echo was that Lindsey is more of a microwave solution to a crock pot problem. So sure, you might have some instant success right off the jump, but soon as the next best job offers itself up, Hunter will be out of there like a bad habit. And what they were looking for was someone with a vested interest that could build a program. Now, there is a twofold message, in my opinion. You want to be able to build a program, but you're also going to have to invest in that program to make sure that you give yourselves the best possible opportunity of winning, regardless who's coaching. And that goes for any institution, whether it's SWAC, Big Ten, SEC. And speaking of SEC, Texas A&M is in an uproar of bringing back R.C. Slocum, and LSU is dancing in the street for the return of the good son. So the one thing about this athletic business that holds true regardless of the level of competition, fans care, fans will make noise and voice their opinions on what they agree to disagree upon and even what they support. But we'll find out how the Hunter experiment unfolds. We're actually setting up an opportunity for an interview with Coach Hunter and possibly Athletic Director Ford Key. So stay tuned for that. Well, I think that's going to take care of my reporting on today. I am going to exit stage left. I want to remind you that you can follow me on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter at The Mike Prince Show. The YouTube channel is Open Mike Broadcast Network. The website, obnradio.com. And our 24-hour dial-in message line, 713-570-6736. Don't forget to visit the website, become a listening partner at obnradio.com. Click on the PayPal button and make your donation today. I've got to run. You guys be blessed, and we'll see you on the other side.